Joel Alves e isto não é um podcast sobre ciência. É o diário de um cientista. Em 1977, estreia nos cinemas o filme Tubarão. A história conta a missão de três homens para matar um tubarão que aterroriza os habitantes de uma ilha. A popularidade do filme fez dele um clássico do cinema, mas foi uma tragédia para os tubarões. A forma como foram representados na sétima arte instalou nas memórias coletivas de gerações uma percepção negativa, que ainda hoje ameaça esta espécie. O realizador do filme, Steven Spielberg, arrependeu-se da fama que deu aos tubarões, que são tão importantes para os ecossistemas marinhos. Mas será esta a única espécie que tem um problema de reputação? Margareta Lakocic, estudante de doutoramento no Biopolo Estibio, na área da evolução de répteis, estuda víboras e fala-nos do impacto que as percepções têm na conservação. Pelo meio, dá-nos umas dicas de sobrevivência. A página de um diário que começa em 20 de junho de 2020 e vai ser lida em inglês.
We can find some fascinating paradoxes if we think about the human attitude toward wildlife. Imagine an animal weighing up to half a ton with sharp claws and a firm bite. Sounds a bit scary, right? But if I say that I'm talking about the European bear, there is a high chance that fear will decrease or even entirely disappear despite the potential threat. Yet, fear and anger are easily sparked at the mention of snakes, especially vipers that coexist with bears. Since spring 2020, I have spent numerous days searching for nose-horned vipers. The aim was to collect venom samples and explore variations of this chemical weapon. One of the fieldwork sites was in Tara National Park in Serbia, well known for its brown bear population. Local rangers welcomed us, eager to share their knowledge about the area. With excitement and pride, they spoke of the bears they saw in the forest or mothers with cubs crossing the road just a few meters in front of their car. They showed deep respect for the bears and were even happy to cross paths with them. However, as soon as the topic of snakes appeared, the rangers' faces turned pale. Their discomfort was undeniable, and they made it clear that they didn't even want to hear about them. While perhaps extreme, this reaction demonstrates the deep-rooted fear that snakes can evoke in people. For years, I have been captivated by the fact that these tiny, limbless, and frequently harmless animals can cause such strong emotions in us. When it comes to venomous snakes, their bite can indeed lead to serious health issues. However, the bite can be avoided by being aware and behaving responsibly. Most encounters occur when we enter their home, and hardly ever it is the other way around. Also, let's not forget that snakes are essential in ecosystems, both as predators and prey. This understanding, and the fact that humans are not their preferred prey, can help us appreciate them more. On a practical note, what should we do when visiting their home? The easiest way to protect ourselves is by dressing appropriately and being aware of where we step, sit, and place our hands. Wearing hiking boots and long pants can protect us from scratches, bug stings, and snake bites, all things that we want to avoid on a pleasant Sunday hike. If we stumble upon a snake, we should let it go its own way, which will be escaping from us, trust me on that. However, if the snake feels threatened and trapped, there is a high chance that it may bite. If that happens, don't panic or seek revenge by killing the snake. Instead, seek immediate medical attention at the nearest hospital. And don't be bitter with the animal because of the accident. The snake just wanted to protect itself. Let's move from fear to a more informed and respectful attitude towards snakes. Then, perhaps, we can even develop admiration for these fascinating animals.
Querem folhear mais páginas do diário desta cientista? Encontram o texto da Margareta Lakocic no site do Público, com o título em inglês Exploring the Venomous Secrets of Europe's Most Dangerous Viper. Para não perderem nenhum episódio do Diário de um Cientista, sigam o podcast no Spotify, Apple Podcasts ou na vossa plataforma preferida. O Diário de um Cientista é produzido por mim, Aline Flor, jornalista do Público, e pelo Joel Alves, investigador do Biopolo Estibio e da Universidade de Oxford, que ouviram no início do episódio. A sonoplastia é do Nuno Coelho e as ilustrações são do André Carrilho. O projeto Diário de um Cientista nasce de uma parceria entre a Associação Científica Biopolis e o público através do Azul. Durante o mês de agosto, vamos publicar histórias de investigadores sobre o mundo vivo à nossa volta. Não deixem escapar as páginas deste diário.
O público fica no ouvido.